The fact of the matter is he lives. That he rose again, he lives. He is victorious over death. We, the reason we are here, the reason that we are being, the reason that God loves on us is because he died on Friday. But early Sunday morning, he got up with all power in his hand. I don't know about you, but I came to the house of the Lord expecting something today, expecting a God to move today, that God will have his way. So let us bow our heads and we'll, Father, we bless you. Thank you for this worship experience. Thank you, Lord God, for the story. Thank you that it never gets old, God, but you continue to keep freshness about it. Thank you for the cloud of witnesses that will gather today, that will worship you. Thank you for baptism this morning, for the one who said yes to you and took a dip in the water. God, the only reason that we can live is because you died. But not only did you die, you rose again with all power in your hands. And so, God, we've come to worship. We've come to celebrate. We've come to cast our cares aside. We've come to be free in you. We've come to freely worship you. God, this is our prayer. Now have your way like only you can. In the name of Jesus the Christ, we pray. And the people of God said together, amen, amen, and amen. I'm going to encourage you to continue to stand on your feet as we go in our praise and worship, as well as our congregational hymn.
And bruised for our iniquities. By his stripes we were healed, as he hung there in Calvary. He was lifted up from the earth in order to draw all men. It was love that held him there. They covered our sins.
It wasn't the heaven to the cross. He got down, come down from the world.
so loved the world that he gave his only son. No better love has been given, given to anyone. And the son gave his life and taken of men. He had the power to lay it down. Oh, he had the power to take it up again. Jesus, y'all. Yes, I am. I'm talking about Jesus. He rose with all power. He had all power in heaven and in earth. We stop by to tell you he's got power. Power to heal. Power to raise, y'all. Power to heal, y'all. Power, 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 power. He's got power, power. Heal, power to pray, power to live, power to walk right, power to talk right, power to live, power, 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 power to walk right, power to pray right, power to live right, power to talk right. Power to walk right. Power. 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 Power.
In all the world around me, I see his love in me, and no one else.
He walked with me. Let's look at that last verse. Rejoice, rejoice, O Christian. Come on, lift your voices together. He lives.
He lives.
Christ Jesus.
Christ Jesus lives.
Oh yes, he walks with me. Yes, he lives. Come on, one more time. You ask? Within my heart. Now, if you know that you're serving a risen Savior, come on, bless him. Come on, with the fruit of your lips, with the clapping of your hands, with the stomping of your feet, let the world know that we're serving a living Savior. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. Good morning, church. Good morning. Happy Resurrection Sunday to each and everyone. Why don't you give yourselves a hand? You all look good today. Amen. What a wonderful Easter Resurrection Sunday it is. Amen. We have had a joyful time literally all week. Amen. We've been in various services all week, and we've been in a revival. Amen. And then we had service on Friday, Good Friday service, and then we went over to community Friday night, amen. Then we did the Easter egg hunt on yesterday, and we had all kind of folk at the Easter egg hunt. Then this morning, early in the morning, early in the morning, we were able to, and we were privileged to witness the baptism of our own sister Tiffany Washington. What a wonderful day to get baptized on Easter Sunday, amen. And then, of course, the 7 o'clock saints, the early morning saints, they came out and got their worship on, amen. And I'm anticipating that in the 10 o'clock worship experience that we will get our worship on as well, amen. Amen. We're so grateful. Today is a great day. We are presenting Matthew 28, He has risen, in a different way than what we have done in the past. But before we get into all of that, we want to have our welcome. And Sister Deborah Campbell Ford, if you would come forth and, amen, give us our welcome. We would appreciate that. Thank you, deaconesses, for dressing the altar. It's dressed for victory. Yes. It's dressed in all white because he got up with all power in his hands. The deaconesses stripped after Thursday. We removed all the covering of the altar to symbolize how Jesus was stripped. And it remained that way Friday and Saturday. But if you noticed it this morning, it's dressed. is full. Amen. And so come give us our welcome. After our welcome, we'll be led to the throne of grace by our very own chairperson of our diaconate, Deacon Potts, and then we'll move into the worship experience.
Welcome, welcome, welcome on this Resurrection Sunday to Mount Olive Baptist Church of Hackensack, New Jersey on 2024. We are blessed to be here. If we have visitors or you haven't been here in a while, please stand so we can acknowledge you. On behalf of our pastor, Reverend Dr. John O. Page, Lady C, the deacons, the deaconess, the trustees, and the family of Mount Olive Baptist Church, we welcome you. We thank you for attending. If you have questions or you'd like to talk to us further, please give us a call at 201-489-6888. I never remember the phone number, but that's the phone number. Anyway, thank you, and I just want to take a moment to thank the family of Mount Olive for your prayers and your thoughts as I went through my illness, and I just want to thank you for your prayers, and I thank God for giving me an opportunity to thank you.
Come on, we welcome you.
We welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. We welcome you. Welcome to the house of the Lord.
Come on, one more time. We welcome you.
We welcome you.
Oh, yes, we do.
We welcome you.
We welcome you. Come on, where we clap our hands. Where we clap. Come on, let's worship. Receive the word. Welcome to the house of the Lord.
Welcome to the house of the Lord.
Welcome to Mount Olive.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Resurrection Sunday, we are blessed yes. to be here because God woke us up another morning yes. to give us another opportunity to try to get it right, to try to get it right. I laid down the sick and shut-in list in front of God so that he already knows. He knows your prayers. He's going to take care of it for us. Take it off our shoulders and put it on his. But I just want to mention two names. Taz Micho, who was on the list. She's here today. And another name that has been on the list for a while, I don't know if she's here now, but she was supposed to come, Miss Eartha Brown, who was supposed to come to church today. She's on her way. She's been on the list for a long time. Yeah. When prayers go up, brothers and sisters, blessings come down.
Amen.
Let us pray. Thank you, God, and just use me as your servant today. I just want to pray for time, Father God. I just want to pray for time that you thought of all of us a long time ago, before we were even a sparkle in our mother and father's eyes. You made sure that we were chosen for you, Father God. So I'm praying for that time, and thank you, Father, in advance. I want to thank you, Father, for the times that you, when we were going left, you made us go right. I want to thank you, Father, for all the times last year, 365 times, Father, you woke us up. I want to thank you, Father, that every time that we got in the car this past year and last year, you got us to work and got us home safely. I want to thank you, Father, for all the times when we woke up, we had a roof over our head, Father. We had food in our stomach, Father. We had clean water, Father. I want to thank you for all the times, Father, that when we read the Bible, we understood you. When you parted the Red Sea, Father. When you saved each and every one of us, Father. Even though that we're not where we're supposed to be in life, Father, we have you to take us where you want us to go. We love you, Father. We honor you. We thank you for the blood, Father. We thank you for this holy week. This week, Father, we had a lot of things going on at the church, Father. But you know what, Father? We don't care. We don't know how tight we are. We don't care. Because you know why, Father? You were in the mix. We had a preacher, Father, that taught us about the high mountain and the low mountain. And you only learn from the low to the high, Father. Yeah. But you know what? Each and every mountain, each and every pass is because of you. Yes. Everything's because of you, Father. We love you. We honor you. We praise your name, Father. If we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't praise you enough, Father. We thank you for all the people on the sick and shut-in list, Father. I thank you, Father. Most people don't know, but you opened the vault for Russia, Father, and they showed the original Israelites. And you know what color they were? People of color, Father.
Come on now.
They were people of color. People try to deny it, but we know and you know, Father, who the original Israelites were. So I just want to say thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for my wife, Father. Her birthday's tomorrow, so I want to make sure
that
the blessing that you gave me 35 years ago, Father, that everyone knows how much I love my wife, Father.
Amen.
Thank you for waking me up every morning with her next to me. And all those, Father, who you have your loved ones, you wake up. Thank you for the children that you blessed us with, Father.
Yes. Yes.
Might not be where you want them to be, but we still love them anyway, Father.
Yes.
Thank you for my grandmother. Thank you for my mother. Thank you for the longevity of keeping her here for all these 85 years. I thank you, Father. I have so many things to thank you. I'm a blessed man.
Yes.
I'm blessed, Father.
Hallelujah.
So I just wanted, it's my last thing, just praise this church, Father. Just bless this church. Bless the pastor.
Amen.
Bless all those, Father, who don't have enough to eat. Bless those, Father, who are in the streets. We have a lot of violence, Father, because you know why? People don't know you.
Amen.
If they knew you, Father, they had the light that we have inside of us, there would be no more violence. There would be no more violence. So, Father God, I just want to say we honor you. We love you. We praise your name each and every day, Father. There's 24 hours in a day, but we need 48 just to praise you for all that you do. These and all things, Father, I say in your Son, Jesus Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
I'm so glad we got some praying deacons around here. And I really admire the fact that they started laying the prayer list before the Lord. Let me show you what that teaches us. To lay, what? Come on and give it up. Can we? Come on now.
Prayer works. Prayer works. Prayer works. Prayer works. There are living witnesses. There are witnesses here that can testify that prayer works. As a matter of fact, you ought to touch your neighbor and tell them you are the evidence that prayer works. You know how I know? Because your mama prayed for you. Your daddy prayed for you. You had church people that prayed for you. If you are here right now, it's because God has worked on your behalf. There's been some prayers in your life, and you are evidence that prayer still works. Thank you, mama, for showing us that prayer still works. You are evident that we serve a risen God. Amen and amen. I'm about to shout out. Anybody know that prayer still works? Anybody ever been pacing up and down and you've been quickening and wondering and waiting? But just to have a little talk with Jesus. Thank you. Deacon, for a little talk with Jesus, it makes everything all right. Can I get a witness? Today,
thank you, God.
Just a little talk with Jesus makes everything. Everything all right. In the gospel, according to Matthew, in the 28th chapter, we hear these words recorded between verses 1 and 7. Text says, after the Sabbath, after Saturday, at dawn on the first week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. Text says there was a violent earthquake. The angel of the Lord had come down from heaven and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone. An angel sat upon it, almost as if to say that he's victorious, sitting on the stone. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He's not here.
Hallelujah.
He has risen just as he said he would. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples that he has risen from the dead. He is going ahead of you in Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell the disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them. "Greetings," he said, and they came to him and they clasped his feet. They touched him. More evidence that he had risen. And Jesus said, "Do not be afraid, but go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." Today, as we contemplate and we reflect on Matthew 28, we are reminded that in the midst of sorrow, out of everything that happened last week, on Thursday, he was betrayed. He was arrested. He was tried on trumped up charges to be the king of Israel. On Friday, he was passed between Pontius Pilate and many others. The crowd said, "Give us Barabbas." Innocent man was found guilty. Out of all of this, being fully divine and fully human, he could have angels down to assist him. But the text says in John 19:28, all things have been completed. And he gave out a loud shout that it is finished. And on Friday he died. But I've got breaking news. We are live, we are live, we are live from the empty tomb. We have breaking news live from the empty tomb. And we're going to interrupt this programming right now to find out what's going on at the empty tomb. Today we got some ladies that are going to share the story. What is going on at the empty tomb? We'll now have the Risen Promise by Sister Jalise Page and Sister Barbara Page.
After the Sabbath, at the dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb.
Do we have enough nard?
We got it. We have enough.
Has to smell perfect. Do we have enough spices? Do we have enough oils? Do we have enough incense?
Mary, we have everything. Now, come on. We have to figure out that stone because it's only the two of us.
I can't believe what they did to Jesus. And poor Mary, to see her son like that. How could people be so cruel when all he was trying to do was help? I haven't seen you shed one tear. Aren't you angry?
How dare you? How dare you say that to me? Yes, I'm angry. I was there when they were nailing the nails in his flesh and bones. I witnessed the hurt, the beatings, and him crying out. Yes, I was there. You don't know the hurt that I'm carrying inside of me. You don't know. And it can't get that sound out of my head over and over and over and over again. If I start crying now, I'll never stop crying. So now, come on.
I can't do this.
You're shaking. I understand. I understand. Come on, we must do this. We have to do this. Come on.
You know, you were Jesus' favorite.
No, I wasn't his favorite. Jesus loved everyone. He loved his followers. I mean, he loved people that didn't even love him.
And he listened. He really listened. I felt seen by him.
I remember when I met Jesus. You know, he healed me. There was something all inside of me, all mixed up, and he just spoke and he released it. And I felt pain. I've seen him heal many. And you know, Jesus would walk into a room and the whole room would just light up and smile.
Yeah, Jesus did have a great smile.
Yeah. So come on, we have to go because we've got a ways to get to that tomb. Okay.
there was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of this that they shook and became like dead men.
And no tomb is somewhere. It's right about here.
Oh my Lord, I'm a dead girl. We gotta go.
What's happening?
My goodness.
Are those soldiers dead? Oh, what's happening? Oh my God, the stone's gone. What's going on?
Do not be afraid. I know you're looking for Jesus. He is not here. Come and see the place where he lay. God is telling the disciples he has risen from the dead. He is on his way to Galilee, where you will see him.
Are we dreaming?
No, I don't think so. Wait. This is real.
What?
Oh my, Jesus is not here. He has risen. Oh, Mary, come on, we got to go tell him.
Guess I won't be needing these anymore.
Come on, Mary.
Oh my goodness. Jesus is risen. Hallelujah. Jesus is risen. Oh my goodness.
Mercy endureth forever. wondrous is thy name. Heaven and earth, thy greatness proclaim. Every knee shall bow, and every tongue confess that Christ is Lord.
Reporting back from the garden, where the empty tomb was. Text tells us in Matthew 28, verses 8 and 10, so the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid, yet filled with joy. And this is what I like. Text goes on to say that in verse 9, suddenly, in the midst of them being afraid, Jesus met them. Greetings, he said. And they came to him, and if they needed further evidence, the angel already said, look in the tomb, he's not here. But if you need further evidence, the text says that they fell at his feet and that they clung to him. They held on to him and they worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, and this is really what got me messed up last night. He says, do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers. This is the first time in the Gospels that Jesus refers to his disciples as brothers. Now, why should that excite somebody today? Because these are the same dudes that when he was hanging on the cross abandoned him and deserted him, and even though they abandoned and deserted him, Jesus still calls them brothers. Somebody ought to be excited right there, because every time we have abandoned God, every time we turn our back on God, God still calls us his son. He still calls us his daughter. He still loves on. Is there anybody in here that can say, thank you, Lord, that you haven't abandoned me? That's good news. That's good news. And he blessed my soul. Nelson Clark, come on.
Just one look, one look at Jesus, and my cares will all pass away. Only one look was all I needed. Now my life will be forever changed. Then I saw him. Yes, I saw him. And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul without a word. And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul. Yes, he blessed my soul without a word.
Then I saw him.
Yes, I saw him.
Yes, I saw him.
And he touched my soul.
He
blessed my soul.
And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul. Without a word. And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul.
my soul. Yes, he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul without a word.
And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul. And he blessed my soul.
With a
oh.
come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. The Bible said that as Mary were going to the brethren, y'all can keep that groove going, keep that groove going. That as they were going to talk to the brethren, the Bible says that they were experiencing some sadness. They were experiencing some darkness. But somewhere in the journey, Jesus showed up. And when Jesus showed up, the Bible says he greeted them and they fell down and worshiped him. And then it says that they proceeded and they had joy in their hearts. How many know that God will turn your sadness into gladness, that he will change your darkest days into brighter days? Is there anybody in here that don't mind and has some joy and can stand up on your feet and say, I've got joy? Come on, choir. Where my singers and sopranos at? Come on, y'all. Y'all ready? Somebody ought to get your dance on right now. Has God been good to anybody right now? It's all right if you dance and give God some worship. It's because he's put joy in our hearts. You better praise him on them drums. You go ahead and praise him on them drums. Mike, I know you got something on that bass. Go ahead, Mike. Come on, Elder, I know you got something. We just talking about joy. We just having a Holy Ghost party. Do you mind if we party a little bit? Is there anybody that got joy with them? Go ahead. Why are y'all ready, joy? Joy. Joy in here. Amen. Woo! Look, first off, I'm gonna need y'all to turn that AC up. The Holy Spirit is in here. The church about to catch on fire. Folk about to start running around and experiencing joy in their life. Woo! Amen. At this time. Somebody's thinking about had it not been for the Lord on my side. Oh, where would I be? You might as well praise him right now. This is a good day. He's got victory over the cross. To praise and worship him. Worship him, he's been good. Worship him because of his provision. Worship him because of his healing. Worship him because of his delivery. That's a war cry right there. You know what this war cry means? It signifies something to the devil. That enemy, you ain't got no... We might as well let the devil know that we got victory. Somebody used to dance on Friday night. You might as well dance in the church. I was just sitting here thinking, I do that sometimes, but I was sitting here thinking, what if we didn't have no music? What if we didn't have, would you still have joy? Would you still have a rhythm inside of you? Would you still have a praise inside of you? Would you still have Thanksgiving inside of you? Could you still have a dance inside of you? What if we ain't had no music? Where are the worshipers at that just got joy? Who just understand that God's been good? Who have been healed? Who have been delivered? Who have been saved? That's what we did down south. All we did was hit our feet. Let's just try that right there. And then somewhere along the lines, you begin to think, God, you so been good. And that rhythm will get down into your soul deep. And I remember the old church mothers will be groaning away. Sometimes you ain't got no words for prayer. But the Holy Spirit intercedes and begins to groan on our behalf and begins to talk to the Lord. And sooner or later, you start worrying about your troubles because God gets down inside you and you start praising. Woo! All right, let's stop. Woo! Amen. Listen, we still got an opportunity to worship. We just halfway through, amen. We halfway through the text. We are halfway through the text. We're going to take a pause in the text so that we all can participate in worship by the giving of our offering, our tithes. Ooh, I don't got out of breath. If you're watching online, the Lord's been kind. Amen. We're going to put up the ways that we can give. You can give by Givelify. You can bring your offering traditionally. You can sit in the 260 Central Avenue. Amen. Today is a good day that we may bless God, who has given us everything we have, including his son Jesus. And do you know, because he got up, you can get up as well? And whatever you might be lacking, God has for you. Would you just trust him enough? Amen. God is an awesome God. You cannot beat God's giving, no matter how hard you try. Let us pray. Father, we bless you. We thank you for the precious privilege to give back to you that which you have given to us. Thank you for giving us your son, Jesus, who lived, who died, but who rose again. God, we bless that you will bless these gifts. Let it be used for the healing of your body. We thank you that we see the results of these blessings by how we're able to bless the community. Thank you for the generous hearts. Thank you that we can give cheerfully and not tearfully. Thank you that we can trust you, that you will bless us back, that you will shake it up, press it so that it runs over. God, we thank you. In the name of Jesus, we do pray. And the people of God said together, amen, amen, and amen. Please follow the direction of the usher. praise God, from whom all blessings flow. May we please stand. Praise God. Be seated. As we continue,
amen, amen,
in this 28th chapter of the Gospel according to Matthew, we pick up the women have been called to carry the message and carry it to the brethren. They become the first evangelists.
All right. Come on now. Yes, they were.
Indicating in a time and era where the message of woman were not received. They go and preach the gospel and what they've seen. And while they're over there, I need us to understand that Mary and the other Mary were not the only ones present at the empty tomb. The Bible says that there were some guards there. And the guards were scared, shaking in their boots because of the report of the empty tomb. We pick up at verse 11. Says, while the women were on their way, some of the guards went into the city and reported to the chief priests everything that happened. And when the chief priests had met with the elders and devised a plan, they gave the soldiers a large sum of money, telling them, you are to say, his disciples came during the night and stole him while he was sleeping. If this report gets to the governor, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble. The soldiers took the money and did as they were instructed. And this story has been widely circulated amongst the Jews even to this day. Some people believe that the good news of the empty tomb is fake news. Over the last few years, fake news has dominated the headlines. At its core, we can define fake news as news stories that are false, stories that are fabricated with no verifiable facts, sources, or quotes, sometimes stories that fit an agenda. Lest we think that ex-president Donald Trump is the first person to coin fake news, I'm here to tell you that 2,000 years beforehand, that there was some Sanhedrin leaders that got together with the report of the soldiers and they concocted some fake news. We have to understand something, that they never denied the resurrection. They just try to cover it up. Some people can't handle the truth, and they try to cover it up. Don't be the witness that tries to cover it up, but be the witness that shares the story. Our next presentation, Sister Lindsay Cobb and Madison Langston, Sovereign.
can do whatever he wants to do. He can do whatever he wants to do when he wants to. God can do whatever he wants to do where he wants to, how he wants to. Because he's sovereign, God is God. Who am I to question wisdom?
I am nothing.
Who am I to question God's judgment?
I am nothing.
Ooh, Lord. That's all right. It's All right. In verse 16 of the 28th chapter, text says, then the 11 disciples, who Jesus now called his brothers, went to Galilee to the mountain Jesus told them to go. And when they saw him, they worshiped him. And Jesus said to them, all authority. That ought to make somebody shout right there. You see, he had already told them that nobody could take my life. But I have authority to lay it down. And the same authority I have to lay it down, I have to take up again. He told them that if this temple be destroyed, 3 days later, it will rise again. He tells the disciples, therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them, Sister Washington, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to obey everything I've commanded to you, and surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. We see Jesus giving the great commission to the disciples. First, in the earlier part of the chapter, the angel invites the women to come and see the empty tomb. And by the time we get to the end of chapter 28, Jesus is now saying, go and tell somebody about the empty tomb. Matthew 28. Come on, Reverend Burt.
Destroy this temple in 3 days, I will raise it up.
Rope. Rope. Oh, 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 oh.
his countenance like lightning and his raiment. His countenance and his raiment. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. The story lightens. Fear not. Fear not. Fear not. For I know.
For I know. He's in Jesus who was to me.
He is not. Here. He is not here. He is not here. Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here. For he has risen as he said. See the place where the Lord used to lay. Let's review the story one more time. The angel of the Lord came to the women, and when they got there, he spoke to them and said, fear not. Fear not. Fear not. For I know.
Can we put our hands together and celebrate? Celebrate. Celebrate the fact that he lives. The psalmist says, because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, fear is gone. Because he lives, I know who holds the future. Can we sing that, a little bit of that? Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know if you believe that, would you join me in singing that?
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know he holds the future. And life is worth living because he lives.
Keep playing that in the background. I'm going to ask that everybody would stand at this time. Today we have seen and we have heard the resurrection story in Matthew chapter 28. Now, I know somebody might be saying, well, Pastor, ain't you going to preach? We already did. That was the sermon. You want to hear me preach? Tune in to the 7 o'clock service. Go home and watch it on Facebook. I was preaching. I preached hard, too. I couldn't do two back-to-back. Amen. And I want to see you next week. Amen. Amen. Because the story is not over. Because he got up. He got up to empower us. In the book of Acts, we see the results of the resurrection. And we see community coming together. And we see disciples being empowered. And we see disciples taking the word to strange places. God has work for you and I. We have a world to be concerned. We have a neighborhood to be concerned about. We got family to be concerned about. Come on back next week. Amen. It's a pretty cool church. Pretty good worship experience. Amen. Amen. The doors of the church are open. There might be somebody here today that has seen, that have heard this word, that has pricked your heart, and you are asking that question, what must I do in order to be saved? I want to let you know something right now, that salvation, there's nothing that you have to do that is magical in order to earn salvation. As a matter of fact, it's a free gift. Jesus died for you. He loved you so much, he stayed on the cross for you. Amen. Not only did he die, but he rose again. And so the doors of the church are open for somebody who might want to receive Jesus Christ right now. Amen. There might be somebody who's interested in uniting with the body of Christ. If that is you, would you come? Amen. If that's the case, I'm just going to lift up a word of prayer. Father, we bless you. We thank you for what our eyes have seen, what our ears have heard. We thank you for the good news. Thank you, God, for the empty tomb. Thank you for the evidence. And thank you that we can receive this good news and take the assignment to go tell somebody else. Thank you for sharing it with the women. Thank you that the women shared it with the brothers. Thank you that the brothers shared it with the world. Thank you that they shared it with us. And now we too can go and tell the story of how we made it over, because God met us where we are.
and Jesus touched our souls. God, we thank you for this Resurrection Sunday. We thank you that you're able to turn sadness into gladness. We thank you, Lord God, for restoring the joy within our hearts. Lord, I pray even now for families. I pray for marriages. I pray for singles. I pray for the wars that are going on in our land and across the pond. I pray for immigrants, Lord God, and for those, Lord God, who might be suffering in sickness even now. God, I lift up those who are suffering in poverty and economic tribulation right now, Lord God. And God, we lift up those who may be spiritually impacted, even weighted down right now. But God, we know that through you, we're able to have victory in all things. God, we thank you for your victory. Thank you for your blood. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your peace. Thank you for your presence. Now, Lord God, as we prepare to depart this place, whenever your presence, my prayer is that you would continue to walk alongside of us. Continue to shape us and grow us. God, we thank you that we're not what we used to be. But God, we're grateful for that because we know you have more for us. Help us to be better and not bitter. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling, who is able to present us before his throne of grace. May power, peace, dominion forever be his. And all those upon my voice said together, amen, amen, and amen. The choir, amen. Before we dismiss, I would ask that we would sit back down. The choir is going to come back with one more selection, and then we'll be ready to go home. Amen. Come on, choir. Y'all got one more? Yeah.
Savior in this world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. You ask me how I know he lives.
He lives in my heart.
Hey.
He lives in my heart.
Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
He walks with me and talks with me along a narrow way. Savior in this world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hand of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. You ask me how I know he lives.
Yeah.
Jesus. Christ
Jesus.
He walks with me and talks with me along a narrow way.
Salvation.
You ask me how I know he lives.
He lives within my heart.
Yeah.
Hello, Mount Olive. We're so glad you and all of our visitors and friends have joined us today. Here are some things happening now and in the coming weeks. Please take a moment to check this out. You can always keep up to date by going to our website, MountOliveBaptist.org. Join us every Sunday for worship at 9:30 a.m. You can meet us in the sanctuary or via our virtual platforms, MountOliveBaptist.live, Facebook Live, and YouTube Live. There are no seating restrictions, and we are now mask optional. But we ask, if you're not feeling well, stay home and join us via live stream. Either way, we welcome you to Mount Olive. The Coleman Cherry Smith Scholarship is now accepting applications for our young scholars. Applications are available in our church office and on the church website, and they must be submitted by Sunday, April 21st. MOBC Sunday School is calling all youth ages 3 to 12 to meet them every Sunday at 9:30 a.m. for in-person classes. We are so very excited to welcome you back into the building as we strive to learn more about our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Tell your family, friends, and neighbors. The New Jersey NAACP State Conference invites you to a U.S. Senate Candidate Forum on Monday, April 8th, held at the Crown Plaza, Princeton, Plainsboro, New Jersey. Engage with candidates as we discuss crucial issues, share visions for our state's future, and answer your questions. This is your opportunity to learn about the candidates vying for your vote. The doors open at 6:30 p.m. and the forum starts at 7 p.m. You must register. Please see all the details on our website. Our annual Global Mission Sunday will be April 21st during our morning worship. We are honored to have Reverend Dr. J. Michael Sanders, Pastor Emeritus of the Fountain Baptist Church, Summit, New Jersey, as the guest preacher. Please share this with everyone you know. Pastor Page invites the congregation to accompany him to the Christ Temple Baptist Church of Patterson for their Pastor's Aid annual service on Sunday, April 21st at 2:30 p.m. The address is 38 Hopper Street, Patterson, New Jersey, where Reverend Dr. Weldon McWilliams IV is the senior pastor. The Bergen County NAACP is hosting its first Prayer Breakfast Awards program on Saturday, April 27th, beginning at 8 a.m. in the Logan Center. Thank you for tuning in today. We hope you found some inspiration in this worship experience.